bummed the media was, because one art form wasn't enough. Ice Cube.
Back in the 80s, Ice Cube was a rapper and one of the main writers of a lot of songs for the legendary rap group N.W.A. A lot of the classic rap songs that came from the group on their debut album Straight Outta Compton are all thanks to Ice Cube's poetic lyricism. In 1989, Cube eventually left the group because he felt he wasn't financially compensated.
Bye, Jerry. I'm out.
And then that led N.W.A. to make a diss track towards Cube on their second album.
Like a hostage, yo, you should've covered your motherfucking head like an ostrich. Deep in the dirt, cause you was a sucker. And your ass up high so I can kick the motherfucker.
And then, well, let's face it, Cube pretty much squashed N.W.A. with his diss track, No Vaseline.
Goddamn, I'm glad y'all set it off. Used to be hard, now you just wet and soft. First you was down with the AK.
With the L-E-E-C-H-M-O-P, now disgrace to C-P-T. Cause you get fucked at your dream by a white boy. With No Vaseline.
This shit's kind of funny.
Motherfucker got us.
So after a little bit of a solo rapping career, Cube debuted in movies with the rap drama classic Boys in the Hood.
Bear's always trying to start some shit. Nigga can't fight, so he always trying to find some excuse to shoot somebody.
That's why fools be getting shot all the time. Trying to show how hard they is. Ignorant.
Aw, oh, fool, shut up. You be doing that shit too.
This movie is easily one of Cube's best movies because this movie feels very much like an autobiography to Ice Cube. So much so, it actually kind of rivals 2015 Straight Outta Compton.
By the by, if you've seen Straight Outta Compton, Cube's son is surprisingly great at playing his dad. It's, like, really scary.
By the 90s, Cube was starting to move over into more and more movies. In fact, he was even writing and producing. One of the classic examples of this is the 1995 stoner comedy, Friday. Even though this movie really is nothing more but two guys sitting on the front porch getting high all day, this movie has a really good cast, a great sense of humor, and subplots that all come together wonderfully.
Now your mama told me what happened to you yesterday. What? That was stupid. How the hell are you gonna get fired on your day off?
I don't know.
And then they eventually ran Friday into the ground with a bunch of sequels. In fact, the sequels didn't even have Chris Tucker's character. Instead, they replaced him with Mike Epps. Which, no disrespect to Mike Epps, but come on. Smokey, Day-Day, Smokey, obviously.
And you know this, man?
But it's okay, because then Cube struck another movie franchise goldmine with Barbershop. Which they then made a crap ton of sequels to that, too. And they even made a pointless spin-off movie with Beauty Shop.
At this point, it felt like Cube was starting to be in some really, really generic movies. Best example of this being First Sunday, which felt like it was trying desperately to be like Friday. So much so, the movie's even named after a day. And fellow actors Tracy Morgan and Cat Williams feel like they're sleepwalking through this movie. I mean, okay, Cat Williams tries a little bit more than Tracy Morgan, but not really saying much in this movie.
But then Cube hit a new low with the Are We There Yet movies.
Look, rappers eventually get roped into doing really bad entertainment, like movies and TV, which is saying something because Cube also made a really terrible, shortly-lived series based on Fridays, but no one could have saved this movie. It's a generic road trip comedy about a guy who's trying to win over his girlfriend by taking her bratty kids with him on a road trip.
I'm sorry, Nick.
There's nothing more that you can do to this car.
Oh, no!
And the only good thing to come out of Are We Done Yet? Was this meme. Damn it, Cube. But it's okay. Cube eventually redeemed himself with a role that is probably his best character yet. No, I didn't see that. Even though that movie is a huge guilty pleasure of mine, that's not that. That movie's incredibly underrated, but I wasn't gonna say that. No, I was gonna say his character from the Jump Street movies.
Cube's, acting skills fits this character perfectly, since Cube is a professional at playing loud and angry characters. And every scene he's in, he steals it, because he is hysterical.
I know what you're thinking. Angry, black cat. It ain't nothing but a stupid stereotype. Well, guess what, motherfuckers? I'm black, and I work my ass off to be the captain. And sometimes I get angry. So suck a dick!
That is funny. Now, before any of you ask what are my thoughts on Cube's acting methods, I'm gonna let this clip from Double Toasted's review of 22 Jump Street say it for me.
That's all you gotta do is flare your nostrils and say every line like this. God damn it, I'm an actor, and nobody's gonna argue with you.
Yeah. So, I'm the media whiz, because one art form wasn't enough. This is acting.
Just waking up in the morning, gotta thank God. I don't know, but today seems kinda odd. No barking from the dog, no small. And mama cooked the breakfast with no hog. I got my grub on, but didn't dig out. Finally got a call from a girl I wanna dig out. Hooked it up for later as I hit the dough.